This year is about pursuing something great. This year is about the dream that I've had for as long as I can remember. This year is not about showing up. It's about making a statement. Trust me when I say this. The time is now.
What's up, everybody? Welcome back to another video. We're in The Face is Drawn, and this is going to be a fucking hard one today. It's going to be a really, really hard one. 103.2 kilos this morning, all-time lowest weight. In fact, I'll put my pictures up on screen right now. I'm feeling it. But we're in for a little bit of a hamstring and back session. Today we've got Chloe with us. Chloe is one of my good friends. And she's also an Insight supplement-sponsored athlete. So, you know, we're going to get a workout in with her today. Check her out. We'll put the link in the description box. I was saying I'm going to link your Instagram so everyone can be like, I'm going to link your Instagram.
Oh, that's nice of you.
So all the...
teammates.
All the... I'm not even going to say it.
Yes, in. Good.
Big spot.
Go on.
Oh my God. Wow,
you're a
that's too much.
It's freaky.
Sorry.
Freaky doctors.
I haven't been training this year, really. It's one of those, just of all the things that you want to grow as a male bodybuilder, it's not your adductors.
Yeah.
I'd rather freaky biceps. Good, control. Control that way down, come on. Yeah, that's what I want, come on. Good, come on, pull through. One more with me. I'll keep me nice and smooth. So I decided to swap around hamstrings and back. Normally we do back first, then hamstrings, but when you do that, I'm just fucked. I'm just absolutely battered and the hamstrings are so half-hearted, so putting hamstrings first today and then we're gonna go on to back. Strong as fuck, come on.
Hey.
Yeah, you're so good, come on. Hey. Good. Hard, good.
Beat you! Fuck. Such a nice exercise.
It's good, isn't it? Let's fucking drill it. Good. Yeah, strong. Hell. Fair play.
Oh my God.
Fair play.
Can I be honest? I still want your hands up on my body. Can you make my heart beat like a rocket? With me in the wave bar in the morning.
That was close.
Do you want me to be
that?
No.
Yeah.
No. Sorry. Insecure on my own, let alone being in front of Chloe. And then I've got half an hour of cardio.
Right, guys, we're a good few days later. Training with our girl CPT, but today, this morning, we're going for a bod pod, a body scan. So for those of you guys who remember last time we got into the body scan, I was about 113, 14 kilos. I was in my off season, and now I'm like, you know, 12 days out, and let's see what the difference is. So I'm really excited to get into this and just see, you know, how lean I am, the body fat percentage, the muscle mass, and I'm excited, so let's do this. Is it stone half in it? So we're just checking in for the body scan. Not sure why. So I haven't got anything to say. My metabolic rate is going to be unique to me, obviously considering I use anabolics as well. I'm using things that speed that up.
Okay.
So I'm actually still eating like 2,600 calories,
right?
Which probably sounds a lot to most people, but when you're 105 kilos, shredded, using drugs,
yeah,
it's not that much.
Okay.
Also do an hour on the bike, which is about a half marathon every day. I also walk about 7 or 8 kilometers every
day. And what does the strength of the bike do?
That's just aerobic conditioning. That's just that calorie output to change the into more of a deficit.
Right. Okay.
Yeah, but we'll tape it up until then.
So, I mean, a point to bear in mind with DEXA and most measurement methods is we measure lean mass. Okay. So lean mass, where you can often interpret as muscle, but there's a lot of qualitative information about it. For example, so if you were coming off steroids,
yeah,
we expect a huge drop in body water.
Yeah. Right?
If your creatine use would be the same.
Yeah.
So, you know, short, you were here in July, 21?
21, yeah.
Gosh, okay. I'm thinking this was just months ago.
No, a year ago.
Oh yeah, wow. So, you know, we measure from a point in time to a point in time.
Mm.
So water content, big fluctuations in water content, which gear will effect,
yeah, for sure,
are in there. Okay, so we can't look, if you know, if this showed an increase of 4 kilos of lean mass, I can't say to you that's 4 kilos of muscle. All right, there are other things at play, right? Yeah, but nevertheless, you know, it's so over the long term, that's why it's better we say to everybody is really we want to be checking at kind of regular intervals, because then we know we've got a trend,
yeah,
rather than like a, you know, a share price on two different days that could be like that. Okay, Josh, on your back, please, with your head here, remember, on your back. And so you've dropped about 113 to 101 kilos. Mm. So you've dropped about 11 and a half kilos or so. So what's interesting is that, and again, like I said to you just earlier, lean mass is everything, muscle plus. So since that time, you've actually lost about 8 kilos or so of what we call lean mass.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
All right, and 3.5 kilos of fat. Okay, so we take fat as our anchor measurement. We're incredibly consistent for body fat. Okay, so you carried 16.2 kilos before, and you're now at 12.8 kilos now.
Crazy.
Okay. All right.
That makes zero sense in my head whatsoever.
Really?
Zero.
Really?
Because I'm shredded and I was fat and I was 3 kilos.
Yeah, but you've lost as well 8 kilos of
fluid,
cover and fluid. Yeah.
That's crazy. Like, yeah. Like you'd think it'd be much more body fat.
Right. Okay.
But clearly it's just
fluid. Yeah.
Strange.
I mean, I'll put my standing court and say, but for fat we are utterly consistent.
Yeah.
Fair enough. Yeah, but I've had I don't understand gear. Okay, is gear going up or coming down?
It's going
as I mentioned
up.
About you know when you come off steroids, as far as I know,
yeah, you'll lose fluid.
You lose a lot of water.
Yeah, but just losing body weight, you'll lose the fluid. You know?
Right.
Like
yeah.
I don't really hold fluid.
Right. Okay.
Regardless of the amount of gear, really.
Right. So you're certainly not there. But would you have been water fed? You know?
Yeah, I would have been full of water then.
Right, okay. So that's what we is in the result.
Yeah.
Okay. And the other thing as well, like I said, is in measuring 2 points a year apart, we're 1 week away from a year, right? Yeah. So, you know, we're measuring from the 2nd, 12th of July to the 5th of July.
Yeah.
And anything could have happened in that time. And there would have been periods, you know, perhaps there was a period even 3 weeks ago where, you know, lean mass was so much higher.
Yeah.
You know, and on, I don't know where you are on the fat loss journey, but lower, higher, etc. So, you know, people come back and regardless of, you know, being in a competition, but they say, well, let's say it's been a year.
Yeah.
And they say, but that doesn't make sense. I've been putting on weight or I've been losing weight. I say, yeah, in the last 3 months.
Yeah.
But what happened in the previous 9 months to that?
Yeah.
So, you know, let's, to them, just a normal consumer, let's check it as we go. Let's, as soon as you switch regime, let's check it. So let's bulk, check, let's cut, check, let's go, you know, to a new steroid, let's check.
Yeah.
Your lean mass index is above 25.
I'm still not natural.
Still not natural, yeah, so I can tell that.
Good.
It's difficult because so little of you is fat. So last time, remember, we had a high visceral fat reading, right?
Yeah,
that's
yeah.
The internal unhealthy fat. I did two or three other bodybuilders who were on steroids and they all had, you know, to me, quite high visceral fat. It's actually dropped hugely.
Half. So we've halved my visceral fat in that time. And that's something that I notice every time that I do cut. And actually what I find is that even, I might not be right, but like LDL cholesterol plummets.
Okay.
Know? And my HDL is still fucked, but my LDL cholesterol plummets to a very, very healthy place as well.
Right.
Just from the clean food, you know?
Okay, all right.
I'm still overweight as well.
Yes, so you're overweight heading into obesity.
You're at the
end
of it.
Yeah, you're obesity one top end.
Fantastic. No, that's amazing. Thank you so much.
Okay.
That's really nice. Like mind blowing.
Yeah, okay, all right. if nothing else. But I would have loved to know now what that 120 kilos was.
Don't worry, I'll be right there soon.
Yeah, sure. I'd love to do it.
That's really good.
Okay.
And so body scan done. Honestly, it wasn't what I expected. Like 12 and a half kilos on my frame still. I don't know about that. It's a little bit difficult to understand saying that lean tissue, some of that was water. So I'd lost like 9 kilos of fluid, but only 3.5 kilos of fat. since we checked in a year ago, which is very surprising, but the way he explained it, it made sense. So now we're just gonna go, I'm gonna go look at something, and then we're gonna head back home, get a pre-workout in. I've still got like a dodgy meal in my bag I need to eat, and we're gonna go to the gym finally. 9:45, I'm knackered, I haven't eaten since 5, worried on my cardio, then my steps. Oh, gas mat 10 all fucking day. Good session with CPT, Chloe. Obviously, unexpected results there. Only a couple of percent body fat difference. I don't know what I believe so much, but it is what it is, guys. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. We'll be back very soon. I'm 12 days out as of this video. I don't know when you guys will see this, but we're flying to Vancouver a week today. A week today, we're flying to Vancouver. We're coming along with us. Look forward to taking the unpooped. I'm going to go do my cardio. See you soon, guys. Peace and love. Bye-bye.